Have you ever thought of living in a world where if you need water, you cannot just open the tap or go to the vending machine, push the button and get the bottle, a nice clean water to drink? Instead, what if I told you that you should walk at least 20 kilometers a day, say a distance from Tokyo to Yokohama, to get water for you and your families? Would you like to do that? I bet it's a big no. Don't worry. You don't live in the rural India, where people have no connections of water, no pipeline, no source of water for them. What do? There are young girls and women who walk miles together, spending their lives just to fetch the water for their families every single day, missing their school, their jobs, just to get water. India, for that matter, 1.3 billion people live in India, which is, say, 10 times the population of Japan. And of course, the people in India need food. And agriculture is the most important occupation and the main source of income for India, which is why water resources is super important. Having said that, coming to the most interesting part, how does my research contribute to solve these problems? Having a look on the slide, on the left part, this is a data set that the satellite data from NASA has given a very amazing information that in central India, that's my country, by the way, the water levels are rising. This is a blessing from God. And my research is to use this data set along with my knowledge of water studies, combining together and understand the question, why? Why does the water only particularly in this region increases and not in the other parts of India? And why do I want to know this? I want to know this because if we know the reasons that are helping to rise the water up, we can create the same environment in other parts of India and expect that one day, every single Indian or every single person living in India has access to clean and free water, and also help the people to become aware of how important water is and to use it efficiently, and also expect the world go towards a drought-free India. With this, I would like to give you a message today, because water crisis is a global issue. So each one of us should try to save water whenever and wherever we can. Your contribution counts.